Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to study about essential fatty acids. At the end of this video, you should be able to define essential fatty acids, enumerate the examples along with their sources and various functions and various deficiency manifestations. In exam, there can be short answer question on this topic. Or there can be clinical case based question for 5 marks. So let's begin with the clinical case scenario, which is based on this topic. A 24 year old woman who had put on weight after childbirth was advised by her physician to reduce her calorie intake. Being impatient, she stopped consuming fats and oils. Though she lost the excess weight, after a few months, she developed skin lesions on the posterior and lateral aspects of her limbs and buttocks. In the history, it is mentioned that she had stopped consuming fats and oil, and in addition to that, she had developed the skin lesions on the posterior and lateral aspects of her limbs and buttocks. So this shows the condition, that is essential fatty acid deficiency. Now let's understand what are these essential fatty acids. Essential fatty acids are the fatty acids which are not synthesized in the body and they should be supplied in the diet. It means that we get essential fatty acids from the diet. And all these are polyunsaturated fatty acids, that is PUFA. There are two examples of essential fatty acid. The first is linoleic acid and the second is linolenic acid. These are the two important essential fatty acids. There is one more essential fatty acid, arachidonic acid. But as it is synthesized in the body from linoleic acid, it is not considered as essential fatty acid. Now the next question is, why this fatty acid cannot be synthesized in the body? What is the basis of essentiality? Linoleic acid and linolenic acid cannot be synthesized in the body because humans lack enzymes which can introduce double bonds beyond carbon 9 to 10 during the synthesis. And these fatty acids have double bonds beyond carbon 9. Linoleic acid is the first essential fatty acid, and in the C system it is denoted as C18 because it has 18 carbon atoms. 2 means it has 2 double bonds. Delta 9 and 12 shows that the first double bond is between 9 and 10 and second double bond is present between 12 and 13. This is the C system of denoting linoleic acid. In the omega system, linoleic acid is shown as C18 to omega 6 because omega numbering starts from this end, that is methyl end, and here you can see the first double bond is present between omega 6 and omega 7. That's why linoleic acid is considered as omega 6 fatty acid. What are the sources of linoleic acid? Corn oil, peanut oil, cottonseed oil, soybean oil, and many plant oils along with the meat and eggs are the important sources of linoleic acid. The second essential fatty acid is alpha-linoleic acid. In the C system, it is denoted as C18 as it has 18 carbons. 3 means it has 3 double bonds, and delta 9, 12 and 15 shows the position of double bonds. First double bond is present between carbon atom 9, 10, second between 12, 13 and third between 15 and 16 in the C system. While in the omega system, the first double bond is present between omega 3 and omega 4. That's why linolenic acid is considered as omega 3 fatty acid. The sources of linolenic acids are walnut oil, flaxseed oil, canola oil, fish liver oil, seafood, fatty fish, soybean oil. All these are the sources of linolenic acid. Now let's see the functions of essential fatty acids. First, it is required for the synthesis of eicosanoids, The arachidonic acid, which is synthesized from linoleic acid, is required for the synthesis of eicosanoids. Eicosanoids are 20 carbon compounds. For example, prostaglandins, prostacyclins, thromboxanes, leukotrienes, all these are eicosanoids which are derived from arachidonic acid. Second function is, it is required for synthesis of two other omega-3 polyunsaturated fatty acids from linolenic acid. The example of omega-3 TUFA are eicosapentaenoic acid and docosahexaenoic acid. These are derived from linolenic acid and these are required for proper development and functioning of the brain and nervous system. The third function of essential fatty acids is maintenance of structural integrity. That is, it is involved in the formation of healthy cell membrane and structural integrity of mitochondrial membrane. The cell membrane and mitochondrial membrane constitutes phospholipids. And arachidonic acid is 5 to 15% of fatty acids which are present in phospholipid, and that's how essential fatty acids are important for formation of healthy cell membrane, because arachidonic acid is formed from linoleic acid. Phospholipids are also involved in the formation of lipoproteins like chylomicrons, VLDL, LDL, HDL. And essential fatty acids also prevent fatty liver, that is deposition of triacylglycerol in the liver. VLDL formation requires phospholipid and phospholipid require arachidonic acid. And VLDL carries triacylglycerol from liver to peripheral tissues. So indirectly the arachidonic acid is involved in the formation of VLDL, as it is associated with the phospholipid, and that's how it prevents fatty liver. The sixth function is antiatherogenic effect. It is said that TUFA is cardioprotective because the essential fatty acid, that is arachidonic acid, increases esterification and excretion of cholesterol, and thereby it lowers the serum cholesterol level. This has been explained in detail in the video on fatty acids classification and functions in detail. Now let's talk about the case which we have discussed in the beginning. That is essential fatty acid deficiency, which is also called as phrynoderma or toad skin. It is characterized by horny eruptions on the skin, particularly on the limbs, back and buttocks. It is also characterized by scaly skin, eczema in children, loss of hair and poor wound healing. There is impaired lipid transport and fatty liver may occur. Decreased efficiency of biological oxidation is also an important feature of this essential fatty acid deficiency. Essential fatty acid deficiency is rare in humans, but it can be seen in infants receiving formula diets which have a low fat content, or in a patient who are on intravenous nutrition and that nutrition is low in essential fatty acid for a longer period, or it can be seen, as we have discussed in the case, the woman who didn't have fats and oil in her diet. In the next video, we will see the chemistry of triacylglycerol, their functions and various properties.